Royals fans, you've tuned in to yet another Guelph Royals baseball broadcast live here on YouTube. My name is Simon Gladstone, and it is a beautiful evening for baseball tonight. We've got the Barrie Baycats visiting us on the long way. It's probably, a four-hour drive or so from Barrie all the way out here to Guelph? And they made it on time, of course. As I said, my name is Simon Gladstone, and none of the music you can actually hear right now is owned by us. We make no claim to any of this music. YouTube has been giving us some troubles with copywriting issues. Various copyright owners have been coming in to block our videos. You can't actually watch them in most countries at this point. This evening we'll be announcing the names of all the songs that are playing behind me and otherwise in hopes that that will fix the problem. So currently playing is I'm Shipping Up to Boston by the Dropkick Murphys. And we're just... Oh, we actually just finished the lineup actually for the Guelph Royals. Music's just fading out. We'll be hitting O Canada very soon. It's a 7:30 ball game, so of course the sun's setting behind us right now. We have an east-facing ball diamond. Here's O Canada. We'll be right back. As I said, the Barrie Baycats are here visiting us today, and strangely, our starting pitcher for the night is number 36, Marc-Andre Major. And normally, the reason this is surprising is because he is from Montreal, and normally he only comes out for weekend games, and as I'm sure you know, today is Tuesday, and Tuesday is not a weekend. And he's out here tonight, so we should see some good pitching. He's been a pretty powerful pitcher for us so far. And leading off for the Barrie Baycats in just a couple of short minutes, Andre Major is just doing his warm-up pitches now, will be number 16, the right fielder, Ryan Spataro. Second is the second baseman, number 18, Kyle DeGrace. Then the first baseman, number 9, Jordan Castaldo. Fourth is the designated hitter, number 31, Kyle Nichols. Then the third baseman, number 29, Kevin Atkinson. Then sixth is number 42, the center fielder, Jeff Cowan. Then is number 4, Jeremy Walker, who plays left field. Now, when I saw his name on the roster, I actually thought it said Johnny Walker, and I had a whole bunch of jokes up my sleeve. But no, his name is Jeremy Walker, so no jokes for you tonight. Second last is the catcher, number 39, Zach Sardelletti. And last but not least, shortstop, number 8, Branfi Infante. Now, we may have a pretty great pitcher coming in from Montreal, but so do the Baycats. Theirs isn't from Montreal, actually. He's just come down from AAA baseball. His name is Emilis Guerrero, and he's wearing number 21 for them tonight. So we should see some pretty great pitching from both sides. I've never actually witnessed a no-hitter in any kind of baseball, except maybe like T-ball back when we played it, but it doesn't really count because the pitcher stands still and is actually just a black peg sticking out of the ground. It'd be kind of cool if I could witness a no-hitter in baseball like this. And I think we've got the pitchers to do it tonight. In the bottom of the first, once we get there, leading off for the Royals will be at number 31, the center fielder, Tino Silvestri, which is really interesting because most of the time he's at the bottom of the lineup in our cleanup spot, and now he's at the top. Fun days. Second is the first baseman, number 33, Matt Schmidt. Then the designated hitter, who normally plays right field, but tonight I guess they have him in the DH spot, number 10, Chandler McLaren. Then the third baseman, number 5, Aaron Loader, who normally stays out in left field. They've got a pretty big defensive shift on. We'll finish this in just a minute for you. We're getting ready to throw the first pitch. Leading off, as I said, for the Baycats right now, the right fielder, number 16, Ryan Spataro. And having just played behind me was Daniela Denmark by Jonathan Roy. Here's the first pitch of the ball game. Comes in low, ball one. Second pitch is a called strike, low edge. Andre misses just a little high, ball two. Wild pitch gets bypassed Pat Coughlin. He's our catcher today. Ball three.
Look at this. Loader's at third. Max has short. Powers at
second. As I said, there has been somewhat of a defensive shift for us. We've got Brendan Power, of all people. I think normally he plays first base or sits in DH, but today he's on second. Knipe is on shortstop instead of second. McLeod is in right field instead of McLaren. Loader's on third base instead of left field, and in left field is number one, Nathan Dallas Blackburn. Schmidt's still on first, though. Spataro fouls one off, full count. Spataro makes good contact with that. It bounces along the ground out to right field. Base hit to McLeod. Now batting is the second baseman, number 18, Kyle DeGrace. Major misses outside, 1-0. Major watching an empty second base. A really loud yell. That was fouled way off the first baseline. I don't actually know who yelled about that.
I think that was Coughlin that yelled.
Why? Well, we think it was Coughlin who yelled, but why?
Usually the catcher is the one that directs traffic in the infield, so maybe he's trying to give directions to Schmidt.
Maybe the Royals have some new tactics for directing traffic in the infield, because the ball didn't hit him. That was the kind of yell you'd hear when someone has their hand crushed by a baseball or something. But counts even at one. There's a man on first and no out. Top of the first. Baycats batting. And that's a goner. Way over the left field fence. Actually cleared the fence on the far side of the bullpen. That's two runs right there in the top of the first. Baycats take a 2-0 lead with no out so far in the ballgame. Now batting is number 9, the first baseman, Jordan Castaldo. Castaldo takes his first pitch, strike one called. Second pitch, taken inside, 1-1. Thank you. Castaldo fouls one back, strike two. Pretty full crowd tonight. A lot of people out to watch the ball game. As I said, it's a pretty great day for baseball. High 20s still, but should cool off. Should find ourselves in the mid-low 20s by the time the game is over. A decent breeze, and of course, east-facing field, which means you're in the shade when you're watching. Major misses outside, 2-2. If you missed something, or if you'd just like to get a little more information about what's going on in the baseball game, check the link in the description. Make sure you right-click it and press open in new tab, but you can get box score, play-by-play, all in text and a graphic to see where the balls are all going and everything like that. See what exactly is going on. Castaldo hits one way up high into the air. Out to left field, Nathan Dallas Blackburn cleans that up, out number one. And Coughlin is yelling a lot.
He did it again.
But that one wasn't even to the infield. That one was just way up high.
No, but he's directing traffic.
I didn't see. I wasn't watching him. I wasn't watching him. Might have been pointing. And here's their designated hitter, number 31, Kyle Nichols. Now one out with no man on. Two runs already scored for the Baycats. It's the top of the first here in Guelph. Major throws one onto the outside edge of the box, but it's a ball, says umpire, so it's 1-0. Not so lucky that time. Nichols takes a swing and misses. Major fools him again. He makes contact with the ball that time, but it fouls it way off into his own dugout, 1-2. Swing and a miss. But the ball got away from Coughlin. We'll see if the throw... Yeah, throws on time to first. Nichols is a big guy, not exactly a fast runner by any means. That's out number two.
That's one strikeout, four more for fans to win with Buffalo Wild Wings and the Royals.
Delightful. Now batting is the third baseman, number 29, Kevin Atkinson. Major misses up high, 1-0.
No, I thought he missed low.
My listeners don't know that. Swing and a miss, strike one.
We can't go through the ballpark where you can hear us picker in person instead of online.
Swung on and hit hard but along the ground out to third base. Ah, great throw there. Good thing Blackburn ran up to cover that up. Because our third baseman, Brendan Power, definitely wasn't there in time. But shortstop, Trevor Knight, got there, made the throw out to Schmidt on first. That's out number three. After an unfortunate first two batters, a single and then a home run, making the game 2-0 already for the Barrie Baycats, Major kind of got his stuff together, and it went 3-up, 3-down from then on. We go into the bottom of the first, and Royals are already down by 2. And playing behind me now is Live and Let Die by Guns N' Roses. Leading off for the Royals in the bottom of the first will be number 31, the center fielder Tino Silvestri. You know, while I was on my way over here, I saw a really, really well-kept brown Cutlass. Sounded great, too. Seen a lot of muscle cars out last few days, actually. There was a 74 Dodge Charger at the beer store near my place. It was the big one, too, the 440 Magnum. 7.2 liters V8. Normally I say that, but they have to give me the script if they want me to say things.
Well, they didn't give me a script either, so... And they usually give me one.
The one you get is usually the one I use.
No, actually, it's for me. I just give it to you. It's just so I know where things are going. Oh, this pitcher's doing what I think it is.
What?
Oh, he's not. He's just lightly tossing them in, not telling the guys what he's got.
Watch. He's a pretty serious pitcher. He did just come down from the Triple A's.
Watch him just rip him.
Now batting is number 31, the center fielder, Tino Silvestri.
Leading off for the Royals in the bottom of the first, the center fielder, number 8, Tino Silvestri.
31. Oh, he said the wrong number. That's okay.
What did he say?
Number 8. Silvestri takes one on the bottom edge, strike one called. Inside, ball one. Emilis Guerrero, that's the pitcher out there right now from the Triple A's, as I've said a couple times. He's it really doesn't look like he's working too hard out there. He just got Silvestri to swing at one that was way too low. Counts one and two. We'll see if Guerrero steps things up or if this is enough. Certainly throws him a little faster than what we're normally used to out here. Puts one all inside again, counts even at 2.
I'm telling you, his speed is about 95 to 97 miles.
Silvestri gets contact with that, out to second base. Light-handed toss, out to first, that's out number 1. Next up is the first baseman, number 33, Matt Schmidt. See if he has any better luck with Guerrero. First pitch is taken for strike one called. Schmidt takes one low and it's strike two called. Crowd not too happy with the call. Schmidt thinks about going around on that, changes his mind as it's headed inside. Ball one. Oh, never mind. Umpire says that's strike three. Schmidt strikes out standing. Out number two. Now batting is the designated hitter, number 10, Chandler McLaren. McLaren takes a great big swing, and he was too late on it. Strike one. Half a swing, third base umpire says is enough to break the plane. Strike two. Guerrero starting to step things up a little bit. Pitch is slowly getting faster and faster. These are a lot faster than what we normally see. Swing and a miss from McLaren. Strike three, he's out. Three up, three down in the bottom of the first. Baycats keep their 2-0 lead. First inning already over. The bottom half of it was certainly nice and quick. Three up, three down. Two of them were strikeouts. Emilis Guerrero really giving the Royals a bit of a problem. Playing now is Soul Bossa Nova by Quincy Jones and his orchestra. Leading off in the top of the second now for the Baycats is number 42, their center fielder, Jeff Cowan. Major puts one low and inside, ball one. Cowan hits it way up high out to right field, and it's caught by Jeff McLeod, out number one. Now batting is number four, the left fielder, Jeremy Walker. He takes one through the outside corner. Strike one. Another one fools him. Same spot, strike two called. Swing and a miss. Jeremy Walker strikes out for out number two.
Strikeout number two for Royals pitchers. Three more for fans to win with. Buffalo Wild Wings in the lineup.
Now batting is the catcher, number 39, Zach Sandaletti. Sardaletti takes it low, 1-0. Another one low, ball two. Two-o pitch. Hit up high behind Pat Coughlin. He gets under it. Out number three. Three up, three down in the top of the second. Royals pulling their stuff together. Still a 2-0 ball game, halfway through the second inning. It's been three up, three down the last two halves. Now playing is Blue Suede, Hooked on a Feeling. Guerrero is warming up on the mound, but I don't think he really needs to warm up to throw the way he has been tonight. I think I've seen one honest-to-goodness pitch really thrown that he tried on, but the rest have just been, you know, him giving this sidearm little toss over the plate. Now batting is the third baseman, number five, Aaron Loader. Guerrero actually wound up for that pitch, and it fooled Loader. It was a called strike on the inside edge. Loader takes it low, 1-1. Seeing windups now from Guerrero, and Loader gets a piece of it, but it's foul, strike two. Loader lets it come in high. Watches it go right by his face, counts even at two. Taking his chances on one that looked like it was a little too high, and it was a good idea too, as he fouled it back. Staying alive, the count's 2-2. Another slow and half swing, but fouled anyway. Loader's count doesn't change. Loader takes it low, 3-2. Loader makes good contact, but it doesn't have too much power behind it. It just goes straight up and straight back down into Kevin Atkinson's glove on third base. Now batting is the right fielder, number 14, Jeff McLeod.
The batter, the right fielder, number 14, Jeff McLeod.
McLeod swings and hits his first pitch out into the gap out in right field. Not a no-hitter today. I don't know why I'm so upset about that. I just really wanted to witness a no-hitter. Coughlin swings and misses a pitch way outside, strike one. Swing and a miss again from Coughlin, strike two. Swing and a miss again. Pat Coughlin swings and misses three times in a row. That's out number two. Jeff McLeod still on first.
Now batting the shortstop, number two, Trevor Knight.
Now batting is number two, shortstop, Trevor Knight. Knight fouls it off the ground and back into himself. Strike one. Knipe takes one low, ball one. Knipe swings at that one, fouls it back. Fortunately, not into himself this time, strike two. Knipe takes one inside. McLeod thinks about going, but catcher got the ball. Now 2-2 and 2 with the man on. The tying run stands at the plate. Knipe fouls one back, staying alive. Knipe ready at the plate. Here's the pitch. Taken inside. Really tough call there. That could have gone either way. Umpire, if he wasn't feeling too nice, could have called that a standing strike. That would have been it for the inning. Full count now. McLeod starts going. What looked like it was a ball on the outside. Umpire says no, it's a strike. And that's it for the inning. Still a 2-0 ball game through two innings. Into the top of the third, we will go.
So the bottom of the second inning, no runs on one hit, tickets can be purchased at the front gate today or on game day. Be part of Guelph's greatest summer tradition with the Guelph Royals.
Marc-Andre Major will continue pitching. Now playing is ABC by the Jackson 5. I forget that I have to do that sometimes. The leadoff batter for Barrie now in the top of the third as they keep their 2-0 lead is the bottom of their lineup. The shortstop, number 8, Branfi and Fadi. He takes pitch 1, low for ball 1. And Fadi hits it hard out to right field. McLeod gets under it, out number 1. Now batting, the right fielder, number 16, Ryan Spataro. He had a single back in the first. Strike 1 called. Here's the second pitch. Hits him square in the shoulder. He's on his way down to first base. If that's what you get for hitting a single, I wonder what DeGrace is going to get for hitting a homer. I'm just playing around, of course. It didn't look like he hit him on purpose at all. Now batting is the second baseman, number 18, Kyle DeGrace. He hit a home run in the top of the first.
Only 2 runs on the scoreboard.
Takes his first pitch for ball 1. Swung on and hit off the ground out to Andre Major. Throw to first base is on time, out number 2. Now batting, the first baseman, number 9, Jordan Castaldo. Castaldo ready on the mound with 2 out. He takes his first pitch low, 1-0. Takes another one. This one definitely in the strike zone. Now 1-1. Castaldo had to dodge that one so he didn't get hit. Ball two. Pitch in the dirt makes it 3-1. And a pitch way up high from Major makes it 4-1. That's base on balls. Now two men on with two out in the top of the third. Now batting is the designated hitter, number 31, Kyle Nichols. Major misses way up high, 1-0. Just a little low that time, ball two. Coughlin going over to meet with Major, just trying to see what's up. Oh, the, yeah, manager's headed out now too. Playing now is Smooth Criminal by Michael Jackson. Major will stay up on the mound, but he's been given his first warning. Pitch, fouled back, strike one. Major puts one on the outside edge of the box. Strike two called. Swing and a miss. Strike three. He's out. That's it in the top of the third. And no more runs scored for the Baycats, although they were definitely close. They had a man in scoring position with one more trailing behind him. Still 3-0, or 2-0, sorry. Halfway through the third inning now. Barrie Baycats are leading it, definitely have an upper hand in the pitching department. Guerrero has not been struggling at all. He's only given up the one hit so far this game, otherwise it's all been out. No walks, no nothing. We'll see if the Royals can learn his pitching and try to turn things around, but we'll just have to wait and see. Playing now is Killer Queen by Queen. Mm-hmm. Leading off for the Royals now in the bottom of the third, the second baseman, number 6, Brendan Power. Power takes the first one outside, 1-0. Power makes contact and fouls it down off the ground and foul, strike one. Guerrero misses outside, 2-1. Strike 2, swung at and missed. Now 2-2. Foul ball hit off of the post of the grandstands and straight back into the catcher's glove. Staying alive there. Swing and a miss. That's it for Brendan Power. Now batting is the left fielder, number 1, Nathan Dallas Blackburn. Now 0-2, not looking good so far for the Royals this inning. Blackburn hits it off the ground out to second. Here's the throw to first on time, out number 2. Back to the top of the Royals lineup. The batter is now the center fielder, number 31, Tino Silvestri. Sylvester takes the first pitch, way too fast for him. Strike 1 called. Swing and a miss, strike 2. Inside, Sylvester goes up on his toes, ball 1. Ball 2, just low. Now 2-2-2 with no one on. Strike 3 called. That's it for the inning. 3 up, 3 down once more. Guerrero really not struggling here. Definitely the upper hand in pitching.
No, I thought it was.
Still a 2-0 ball game. Three innings gone now. We're a third of the way through. And Guerrero really has yet to struggle. He's given up one hit and no runs. Playing now is Uptown Funk, featuring Bruno Mars, by Mark Ronson. Leading off for the Barrie Baycats now in the top of the fourth is the third baseman, number 29, Kevin Atkinson. First pitch misses, ball one. Atkinson fouls one back, strike one. Foul down off the ground, strike two. Taking our time on this pitch here. Major thinking about what he wants to throw. It was headed into the bottom corner, outside. And it was really dug for. Atkinson saw exactly where it was going and hit it right out into the gap between shortstop and third base, and he gets himself a single. Now batting is the center fielder, number 42, Jeff Cowan. Major misses outside, ball one. Ball two just outside. Now 2-0. Two-oh pitch right down the outside line. Strike one called. Major really taking his time out on the plate today. Especially with a runner on first, he's got a lot to think about and a lot to compete with over on the other mound. Pitch a little high, but generally down the middle. Hit hard out. It probably would have landed foul or right on the line anyway, but Jeff McLeod reached out and got it. Out number one. Now batting is the left fielder, number 7, Jeremy Walker. One out with the man on first. Major really watching that runner. Here's the pitch. Walker hits it high out to left field. And Dallas Blackburn gets it. Out number two. Now Now batting the catcher, number 39, Zach Sardelletti. Sardelletti takes it outside, 1-0. Sardelletti hits it way up high over top of the grandstands. It's strike one. Major misses outside. Never mind, that's not a miss. It was just on the inside edge of the zone, I suppose. Strike two, called. Major puts one in the dirt and gets it by Coughlin. Runner headed over to second. Counts now even at two with two out and a man on second. Major puts another one in the dirt, but Coughlin does stop it this time. Now a full count. Major misses again and sends one down over to first base. Now batting is the shortstop, number 8, Branfi Infante. Major misses, 1-0. Strike one called. And Fanny wasn't expecting that. One and one now with two out and two men on. Major puts one just inside and Fanny leans back, but he probably didn't have to. Ball two. Major puts it up high, 3-1. The 3-1 pitch. Misses. And Major walks another one. Now bases loaded with two out. It's the top of the fourth inning. At the top of the lineup, now batting is the right fielder number 16, Ryan Spataro. Now playing is Pumped Up Kicks by Foster the People. Just for a short meeting over on the mound, managers headed off of the field. Another warning given to Major, he has walked two in a row. Bases are loaded now with two out in the top of the fourth. Spataro thinks about swinging at that, changes his mind halfway, but the ball makes contact anyhow, fouled back. Major throws it just a little bit too low. Ball one. Swing and a miss there. Strike two for Spataro. And swing and a miss there. Spataro can't do it. It's strike three. He's out. Base is loaded. Good save there. Halfway through the fourth inning, the score remains the same at 2-0 after the 2 RBI HR back in the top of the first. Playing behind me is the Rolling Stones. Start me up. Leading off for the Royals now in the bottom of the fourth is number 33, the first baseman, Matt Schmidt.
Leading off for the Royals at the bottom of the fourth inning, the first baseman, number 33, Matt Schmidt.
Don't start it again. No. No. Okay, I wasn't done with doing the asshole with it.
Schmidt takes one, he shouldn't have. Strike two called. Same with strike one. Guerrero puts one too far high. ball one. Schmidt makes contact, but not the good kind. It's a foul ball. Strike two. Strike three for Matt Schmidt. Unfortunate for them. Another strikeout up on the board for Guerrero. Now batting is the designated hitter, number 10, Chandler McLaren. I heard about the second home run. McLaren takes his first pitch. Outside corner. Strike one.
I think it's because you went here.
I was here for the first one. Same spot fools McLaren again. Strike two called. Timeout called by McLaren. Got to fix his gloves. McLaren fouls it down and away. McLaren hits it hard but way foul. It'll land on top of the arena. Count remains 0-2. Strike three, McLaren's out, and the Royals just can't do it. Guerrero is too much for them. Next up is the third baseman, number 5, Aaron Loader. Loader looks like he wants to change this trend of strikeouts. Half a swing from Loader, but it didn't go around. Ball two. Loader hits it hard out to right field, but it's not enough. An easy catch made by Spataro. That's it. That's the third out. Baycats still lead it 2-0 through four, as the Royals are unable to make anything. Really anything at all happen. Guerrero has retired 8 in a row now. That's 3 up, 3 down, last 2 innings, and only gave up his only hit of the game, actually. It was a single back in the bottom of the second. And the music now is Pinball Wizard by The Who. And leading off for Barrie now is the second baseman, number 18, Kyle DeGrace. Swung on, hit hard, right out to Major into his glove. He'll make the throw just because he has to, but DeGrace kept his bat in his hand. Now batting is the first baseman, number 9, Jordan Castaldo. Major throws one way too low. It's a wild pitch. Ball one. Major misses low. 2-0. Hit really hard out to center field. It's way, way, way over the fence. Another home run now for the Baycats. It's now a 3-0 ball game, just a solo home run this time by Jordan Castaldo. And now batting is the designated hitter, number 31, Kyle Nichols. Another wild pitch goes by Coughlin, 1-0. Major looks like he's starting to get a little frustrated. Major misses inside, 2-0. Pitch in the dirt bounces off of Coughlin's shoe and rolls back along the ground. It's ball three. Counts now 3-0 with one out and nobody on here in the top of the fifth. The Baycats lead it 3-0. And Major puts one low, trying to fool Kyle Nichols, but it just doesn't work, and he's out at first base now. Another meeting at the mound. This could be Major's last. We shall see. Playing is Let Her Go by Passenger. Major will stay on the mound, apparently. Very short meeting.
Really short.
One out, one man on, top of the fifth. Batting now is number 29, the third baseman, Kevin Atkinson. He hits his first pitch. For some reason, Loader decided not to go for it at third. He probably could have gotten his glove on that, but I guess not this time. And that's a single. Now batting is the center fielder, number 42, Jeff Cowan, with one out and men on first and second. Cowan jumps back. Ball one. Andre misses outside this time. 2-0. Hit just over Brendan Power's head. He reached for it. He jumped. He really did try. Runner's on his way home. Nichols crosses the plate, and only one run allowed. Now a 4-0 ball game for the Baycats in the top of the fifth. And now batting is number 4, the left fielder, Jeremy Walker, with one out and men on the corners. Swing and a miss from him, strike one. Ball one low. Counts now 1-1 with one out and men on first and third. Swing and a miss there. Strike two. One, two pitch. In the dirt. Runner headed over to second. He's safe. Now 2-2 with two men in scoring position. Yeah. Good contact made, headed out to left field. Blackburn dives, doesn't quite get under it. Poked it with the end of his glove, doesn't look too happy about that. One run in, now a 5-0 ball game. So an RBI single there for Jeremy Walker. And Baycats now lead 5-0. Batting here is the catcher, number 39, Zach Sardelletti. Major misses outside. Ball one. Sottoletti hits it hard out to first base. Throw to second, misses. Run comes in, and runners advance. And another base hit. Out to left field again. Seems to be a trouble spot for the Royals today. That was Branfi and Fani, by the way. Didn't get a chance to see that. No runs scored on that one. Just bases loaded with one out. Another meeting on the mound. This has got to be it for Major. Yeah, indeed it is. I can see a pitcher getting ready to run out here. Can't see the number on him yet, but we'll let you know. This is the 300 Violin Orchestra by Jorge Quintero. Replacing Marc-Andre Major on the mound will be number 22, Evan DeMichel. Here we go, number 16, Ryan Spataro is the batter for Evan DeMichel. Bases loaded, one out, already four runs scored this inning for the Barrie Baycats. It's a 6-0 ball game now in the top of the fifth. First pitch misses just a little low, ball one. He makes good contact with it. It's a ground ball out to second, out number two, and a run scored anyway.
The batter, the second baseman, number 18, Kyle DeBrace.
Now batting is number 18, the second baseman, Kyle DeGrace. First pitch is a strike one called as he lets it go by. Seven nothing ball game now. He fouls that one back into the grandstand, startles one of the fans. It's strike two. Another foul ball, this one over past right field along the first baseline. DeGrace hits it along the ground to Knipe at shortstop. Throw to Schmidt at first is on time. The end of a long inning. Much deserved for the Royals now. It's a 7-0 baseball game. Halfway through, the Royals go into the bottom of the fifth with a lot of work indeed. The music is Creedence Clearwater Revival, Looking Out My Back Door. Leading off for the Royals in the bottom of the fifth, and the right fielder, number 14, Jeff McLeod. Emilis Guerrero still pitching. And that's a slider. That fooled him. Strike one called. McLeod fouls one off, strike two. There we go. McLeod gets a good solid hit out to center field. Unfortunately for him, the Baycat center fielder, Jeff Cowan, got under it, and it's out number one. Now batting is number 8, the catcher, Pat Coughlin.
I have a
Just a little.
We'll work on it.
Coughlin takes strike one called, just a little low. Guerrero misses with a wild pitch. 1-1. Coughlin hits a grounder out to third base. Throw to first easy and on time, out number two. Now batting is number two, the shortstop, Trevor Knipe. First pitch to Knipe, fouled back. Scared the pants off of one of the kids. She wasn't watching. It hit the plexiglass right behind her. Strike one. Guerrero puts one right past the letters. Way too fast for Knipe. Strike two called. Strike three called, strike three swung on and missed. That's it. Fifth inning is over. Three up, three down once more. That's 11 put down in a row. No hits, no walks, no nothing. Guerrero is just dominating the Royals. They absolutely can't get past him. 7-0 baseball game now. Just four innings to go. Now playing is the Creedence Clearwater Revivals down on the corner. Leading off for the Baycats, now in the top of the sixth inning, is the first baseman, number nine, Jordan Castaldo. Pitching is Evan DeMichel. And the moon is actually now up in the sky. I can see it over there. It's pretty much straight in front of me. It's got a nice yellow tinge to it, and it is a full moon tonight. Dee Michelle puts it outside, 1-0. Ball two inside this time. Castaldo gets a good hit there, but it goes way off foul and lands under a picnic table. Strike one. The count is 2-1, with no out and nobody on. This is the first batter in the top of the sixth inning. Castaldo hits it really hard out to left field. Blackburn grabs it but stumbles back and drops it. It's lying on the ground next to the fence. There's base number two. Here comes Castaldo for third base, and there he will stay. Now batting is the designated hitter, number 31, Kyle Nichols. And that's going up on the board as a triple for Castaldo. Nichols takes his first pitch high, ball one. Second pitch. Swung on and missed, strike one. Apparently tonight's full moon is known as the full buck moon. I don't know what that means. Sure. Timeout called by the batter. Well, I mean, he is reading it off of Yahoo on the internet, so... Is the article on Yahoo just a copy-paste from Space?
Probably. Wouldn't doubt it.
Batter hits it off the ground out to the pitcher. Dee Michelle waits to see if the runner's going over to the plate and waits, and then just throws it over to Schmidt for the out.
People didn't know Omar Garcia Parra there.
The batter, the third baseman, number 29, Kevin Atkinson.
Now batting is the third baseman, number 29, Kevin Atkinson. He leans back. Ball one.
Are we keeping you up, Princess?
Yeah, you are. Jays do play tonight. Visiting the Diamondbacks at 9:40 p.m. Eastern. We will still be playing. That's 30 minutes. Dee Michelle misses high again. Ball two. The odds of us... For us to be done in 30 minutes, it would have to be three pitch innings every time. With, like, a couple strikeouts in there. Dee Michelle misses high yet again. Ball three. Third one in a row. Mm-hmm. That one's a strike. Not so lucky letting him go by this time, Atkinson, and it's strike one called. That was a little better. Jump from Knight to catch it. Throw over to Schmidt is on time. Out number two, but still an RBI. Now an 8-0 ball game. We're in the top of the sixth inning. Batting now is the center fielder, number 42, Jeff Cowan. Cowan leans back, passes first pitch. It was way up high. Ball one. Another one up high, 2-0. DeMichel just continuously throwing these way up high. Ball three. Another one up high, four in a row. And Cowan walks.
Skaggs is going out. It's probably the point where he's, because you can see that he's releasing high. So maybe this is the point where Skaggs comes out and asks him if something's wrong or something. Because he's not making the adjustments he needs to.
Yet another meeting at the mound, becoming a bit of a theme of the day. DeMichel remains on the mound.
Now batting the left fielder, number four, Jeremy Walker.
Blue Jay updates.
Now batting is number four, the left fielder, Jeremy Walker. And he takes his first pitch low, ball one.
Blue Jays update just recently, Jose Bautista will be starting his rehab. He's going to begin, I think it's tomorrow, in Class A Dunedin, before he moves to Buffalo on Thursday. Triple A Buffalo on Thursday.
Huh. Ball two inside. DeMichel puts it along the bottom edge of the zone, and it's strike one called. That's a hard hit. That's out to center field, but it was too high. A solid hit, no less. It goes out to Tino Silvestri, and that's it for the inning. Halfway through the sixth inning, it's now an 8-0 baseball game. The Barrie Baycats are leading it. Only one run for them that inning, though.
Player who suffered heart issues while playing. His life was saved by AEDs reason he started the charity 2 years ago to give back and to give life to those in a heart crisis. All proceeds from the Monday, July 25th dinner will go to the Pez Protects Foundation.
Guerrero will continue pitching. Can't see any reason why he wouldn't. Playing behind me now is Survivor's Eye of the Tiger. Royals really struggling with it here today. 8-0 is the score, as I said. Guerrero is really the driving force behind that. Were it not for him, you could speculate at how differently this might have gone. But I mentioned at the end of last inning, he's put down 11 in a row. He's probably looking to make that 14 this inning. He's only given up one hit this game, and it was a single back in the bottom of the second. Were it not for that, it would have been 3-up, 3-down every single inning. And here's Brendan Power, hoping to make some changes here. So far, it looks like he might be successful. Ball one. Strike one this time, swung on and missed. Strike two, swung and missed on again. Counts now 1-2. This is the first batter in the bottom of the sixth. Guerrero misses outside, 2-2. Solid hit by Power. Lots of noise on the bat there. In fact, he broke it. But throw to first was on time, and it's out number one.
He said my name, didn't
he? Batting for the catcher, Pat Coughlin, number 34, Blake Cowher.
What? Coughlin's not, wasn't batting now. It would have been Blackburn now.
Okay.
Now batting is number 34, Blake Cowher. Cowher makes contact, hits it straight out to first, unassisted out number two. Now batting, the center fielder, number 31, Tino Silvestri. Tino takes one on the bottom edge. Strike one called. And he hits that one. That's a base hit. Second hit of the game for the Royals.
I think it was 0-1. I think it was 0-1.
Second hit of the baseball game for the Royals. Silvestri now standing on first with two out in the bottom of the sixth. Now batting is number 33, the first baseman, Matt Schmidt.
Second pitch, 0-1, strike one called.
Schmidt takes one inside, ball one. Swing and a miss from Schmidt, that's strike one. Schmidt takes one on the inside corner. Strike two called. Same spot. Won't be fooled again, though. He hits it and fouls it down off the ground. Schmidt takes one in the dirt, and it gets away from their catcher. Sylvester sprints over and takes second. Now 2-2 and 2 with a man on second. Guerrero has a runner to watch now. Haven't seen him do this yet. Here's the pitch. Hits Schmidt. He's on his way over to first base. Just grazed his jersey. Now two out with men on first and second. The Royals could make a comeback here.
Thank you.
Batting for the designated hitter, Chandler McLaren, is number 20, Steven Satz. Satz takes the curveball, strike one called. Swing and a miss from Satz. Similar pitch, but headed a little further outside. Now 0-2. Guerrero pitches one way outside. Don't think he meant to do that. 1-2. Guerrero misses outside again, 2-2.
Deuces are wild, man.
Aces are wild.
Deuces.
Aces are wild.
Deuces,
2-1, 2-out
in the 2-2 count.
Swing and a miss from Steven Satz. Strike three, he's out of there. That's it for the Royals here in the bottom of the sixth. Despite having two men on base, they were unable to make any kind of a comeback. It's still 8-0, and we've got 3 innings to go.
Still at second. Knife is still at short.
playing is Van Halen's Jump. There's been a defensive shift, as it were. Aaron Loader has moved from third base to left field. Blake Cower, who was subbing for Blackburn, who was on left field, is now catching. And Pat Coughlin, who was catching, is now on third base. Batting now in the top of the seventh is the catcher, number 39, Zach Sartoletti. DeMichel misses outside. Sartoletti's 1-0. Swing and a miss. Strike one. DeMichel misses again. Ball two. Two on pitch, fouled back to even the count at two. Two pitch. Way inside and wild, 3-2. Full count. First batter in the inning. Swings at it, hits it hard, but it's foul. Yeah. Umpires say that landed fair. It's a home run for Sartoletti. Someone's shouting, I hope not from the bullpen, show us where it landed. Just a meeting with the umpires now. One of them said home run. We'll see if they don't change that or what. And they say that's a foul ball, not a home run. We'll try that again. Foul ball. It did go pretty far. If that had been fair, it would have been a home run for sure. DeMichel misses low and walks Sartoletti over. Now batting the shortstop, number 8, Branfi and Fonte. Timeout called, and Fonte needs a minute. And that's strike one called for Infante. Strike two called. Now 0-2 with no out and a man on first. DeMichel misses outside. It's ball one. And Fonny misses high, or DeMichel misses high this time. 2-2. Two-two pitch. Half a swing. Umpire says it didn't break the plane. It's ball three. DeMichel walks another one. Now two men on with no out. Now batting is the right fielder, number 16, Ryan Spataro.
The batter for right fielder, number 16, Ryan Spataro.
Takes his first pitch, past the letters, strike one called. Spartaro jumps back. Ball one. One pitch misses outside. Ball two. Spataro jumps back, ball three. Counts now 3-1 with no out and two men on. Strike two called. He thought about swinging at it and probably should have, but thought maybe it was just close enough not to be a strike. Alas, he was wrong, and here we are. Not too happy about that call. He hits it hard just past power at second base. Throw to Knipe on time, but it doesn't stop the RBI. That's an RBI single. Now batting is the second baseman, number 18, Kyle DeGrace.
Batter, the second baseman, number 18, Kyle DeGrace.
Hits his first pitch out to third base. Throw to first is on time, out number one. Now one out in the bottom or top of the seventh, two runs scored. It's a 10-0 ball game for the Barrie Baycats. And now batting is the first baseman, number 9, Jordan Castaldo. DeMichel misses, ball one. Hit hard out to center field, off the ground once first. Runner stops at third, no RBI on that, just a single. Now batting is number 31, the designated hitter, Kyle Nichols. Curveball fools Nichols, it's strike one called. Ball one misses low. One pitch. Bottom edge of the zone, strike two call. Half a swing, umpire says didn't go. Strike three, not there. It's instead ball two. Two pitch, misses low, ball three. DeMichel misses outside. Ball four, he walks. Base is now loaded with only one out. Now batting the third baseman, number 29, Kevin Atkinson. He hits his first pitch into the ground in right field. An RBI single. another meeting over at the mound, we might see DeMichel on his way out. Playing now is Faithfully by Journey.
The batter, the center fielder, number 42, Jeff Cowan.
Here's number 42, the center fielder, Jeff Cowan. Still one out with bases loaded. The score is 11-0 for the Barrie Baycats, and the first pitch to Cowan misses low, ball one. Ball two, misses low. DeMichel puts a strike on the outside edge, and it's called.
Play something more upbeat, please. I was like, what I have played, I have played. The LOL in your face. Your face with the thumb out.
Counts 2-1 with one out and loaded bases. And Cowan hits it hard into the gap between right and center fields. And just one run comes in. They probably could have had two, but I guess they'll leave it there.
It's called sportsmanship. Yeah. You don't try to run the score off.
And another meeting on the mound. There was just one pitch between the last two. DeMichel is on his way off. Playing behind me is the Pirates of the Caribbean theme song. Now pitching for Evan DeMichel is number 3, Ben Reed.
Who is this? Pitching. Pardon?
pitching for the Royals, number 3, Ben Reed. The batter, the left fielder, number 4, Jeremy Walker.
Now batting is number 4, Jeremy Walker. Still one out, bases loaded. Ben Reed on the pitcher's mound now. 4 runs scored for the Baycats so far this inning. It is a 12-run ball game. Walker hits it along the ground out to shortstop. Double play not possible, but one out anyway. It's now 2 out and another run scored. Now batting, the catcher, number 39, Zach Sardelletti. He hits his first pitch as well. Brendan Power almost got his glove on it, but it got by him out into right field. And there's an RBI single. So far this inning, every single batter except for 2 that have been up and the ones who are currently on base have rounded the bases entirely. 6 runs in for the Baycats so far this inning. It is 14-0. Branfi and Fondi now batting. First pitch is a strike on the inside edge. Swing and a miss from Infante. It's strike 2. Ben Reed throws it. Outside, ball 1. Counts 1-2 with 2 out and men on 1st and 2nd. Half a swing. That counts as a full swing. Umpire looks like he's having a little bit of mercy on the Royals there after they gave up another 6 runs. It is now a 14-run ball game. The Barrie Baycats lead it 14-0 in the 7th inning stretch. This is Take Me Out to the Ball Game, as performed by the KC Youth Symphony. KC being Kansas City. This is the Star Wars Cantina song.
Thank you.
Now batting is number 5, Aaron Loader. Counts 0-2 for Aaron Loader already. We got distracted a little bit. There was a visitor at our media booth. Ball in the dirt comes in. Now 1-2. Big swing by Loader. Made a great big effort trying to get that far, but he fouls it back.
He's like, you're killing Arizona. Like, you know, toss up between time of my life. And
swing and a miss by Loader. Gets a tiny little piece of it. It's foul ball. And that's a swinging strikeout for Aaron Loader. Now batting is the right fielder, number 14, Jeff McLeod. Strike one called for McLeod. Guerrero misses outside, ball one. So despite his laid-back approach to this baseball game, he is still getting a little rusty as the game goes on. McLeod fouls one off, strike two. There we go, a solid hit by McLeod. Off the ground into left field, they give him the hit. Now batting is number 8, the third baseman who started out catching, Pat Coughlin.
Now batting the third baseman, number 8, Pat Coughlin.
Swing and a miss by Coughlin, strike one. Swing and a miss again by Coughlin. That's it for him. Valiant effort anyway. 3 swings and he's out. Now batting is the shortstop, number 2, Trevor Knipe. Swing and a miss from Trevor Knipe. That's strike one. Guerrero misses low. Ball one. Swing and a miss from Trevor Knipe. Strike two. Solid contact from Knipe out to left field. Easy catch, though, and that's it for the seventh inning. Much shorter second half of the inning than the first. Two innings to go in the baseball game. It's 14-0 for the Baycats. And the Seinfeld theme is playing for some reason. I don't understand why. I think our music man's gone completely AWOL. He's playing show tunes. He's texting rude things to his boss, but they haven't shut him down yet.
He ain't my boss.
And this is Avicii feeling good. Now batting again is number 16, the right fielder Ryan Spataro. I don't think it's actually been 12 times, has it? No, it hasn't. First pitch misses for ball one. Another one misses, ball two. Reed misses low. Ball three.
That was Avicii I just played, right?
It was Avicii.
Yeah, because he's saying that was non-Avicii.
Strike one called in the outside corner. Counts now 3-1. Strike two, swung on and missed. Swing and a hit out to second base along the ground by Spataro. Throw to first on time. That's out number one. Now batting is the second baseman, number 18, Kyle DeGrace. Reed misses high, ball one. Reed puts one on the outside edge. Strike one called. Ball two misses away. Reed throws a wild pitch. It's ball three. Few devoted fans remain. It was full stands earlier on. Reed misses outside and a player walks. Next up is the first baseman, number 9, Jordan Castaldo. Castaldo jumps back. It's ball one. Reed's taking his time on the mound this time. Castaldo hits it softly off the ground. Throw to second and throw to first. It's a double play. Royals starting to turn things around a little bit. A thankfully short top half of the eighth inning puts the Royals in their second last opportunity to try to even up the score. It is currently 14-0 for the Barrie Baycats. Now playing is Leonard Skinner's Sweet Home Alabama. Now pitching instead of Emilis Guerrero, number 38, Brandon Catena. And batting now is number 6, Brendan Power. Swing and a miss by Brendan Power. That's strike one. Thank you. Strike two. Called this time. Here's the pitch. Outside, ball one. Ball two, misses low. Power hits it softly up to shortstop. Throw to first on time. Power's out. Now batting is number 34, the catcher, Blake Cower. Swing and a miss by Blake Cower. That's strike one. Blake Cower hits it way up high. And it lands on the ground just in front of the Baycats catcher. Strike two. O2 pitch. Hit hard out to center field. Center fielder runs into the wall catching that one. That's Jeff Cowan, out number two. Now batting is the center fielder, number 31, Tino Silvestri. Sylvester takes it. Strike one called. Another one. Low edge. Strike two called. O2 pitch. What a miss, but Sylvester swung at it and poked it away. It's foul. Katena misses away. Ball one. Katena puts it in the dirt this time, evens the count at two. Silvestri got a piece of it, hit softly on the ground out to shortstop. Throw to first is on time, out number three. Three up, three down in the bottom of the eighth. Royals can't make it up. They've got one last chance in the bottom of this inning. We go into the top of the ninth. The score is 14-0. Baycats have done it on 14 hits. Playing now is Born to be Wild by Steppenwolf. I don't know if you've ever watched the music video for Born to be Wild, but it's a wild ride. I'm so funny. Did you know that the first time the line heavy metal or the term heavy metal was ever used in reference to music was actually in this song? Just now he said heavy metal thunder. That's the first time they've ever used it in music. Leading off for the Baycats in the top of the ninth, the designated hitter, number 31, Kyle Nichols.
That's more like it.
It's close. It's a little behind.
Yeah, it's better than it was before.
Ben Reed's still pitching now. Seems to be doing all right. He misses inside, ball one. Hit way up high. That'll come down in left field. I think I heard someone whistling for it, but Aaron Loader didn't see where it was going and couldn't get it, so a single. Now batting is the third baseman, number 29, Kevin Atkinson. Reed misses away, ball one. Atkinson makes good contact, but it goes foul. We'll see if Coughlin can get under it. Oh, very close. Falls backwards trying to get it. Counts 1-1. With no out and a man on first base in the top of the ninth, Baycats lead it 14-0. He takes a strike. Now 1-2. Ball got away from Cower. Ball two. Reed misses again. Ball three. Full count now. Runner on second. It's run number 15 standing out there. It's a very foul ball, but a few degrees over to the right, and that would have been another home run. Atkinson staying alive. Reed misses away and walks Atkinson. Now batting is the center fielder, number 42, Jeff Cowan.
center fielder, number 42, Jeff Cowan.
Cowan hits it hard all along the ground at shortstop. Throw to two on time. Throw to first is not quite there. Out number one. Now one out with men on the corners. Batting is the left fielder, number four, Jeremy Walker.
The batter, the left fielder, number four, Jeremy Walker.
First was put
on
4-6?
6-4.
Sorry, I was just going back in the conversation and see where everyone's butt.
Reed misses low, ball one. Walker gets contact, hits it on the ground to Reed, who throws it right over Knipe's head and allows a run.
So that's an
E1.
Would that run have counted without the error?
Yes.
Pardon?
Yes.
No, would that run have scored without the error?
Only if you assume it wouldn't have turned the double play.
Batter,
only if
the
they didn't turn the double play.
Zach Sarvaletti.
I'm not giving so I shouldn't give the idea on that.
Well, if you think they would have turned the double play, then no. But if you think they wouldn't have turned the double play, then yes.
You think they would have turned the double play?
Could
have. Yeah, that's what I'm thinking.
Now batting is the catcher, number 39, Zach Sarvaletti. Now a 15-run ball game, as that throw over Knipe's head on two allowed a run in. Sarvaletti hits it right back past Reed into center field and loads up the bases. Bases loaded, one out.
The batter, the shortstop.
And now batting is the shortstop, number eight, Branfi and Funny. This is his sixth at-bat of the game. And he hits it really hard up in the air out to right field. Where Jeff McLeod catches it out number two, and a run comes in.
The batter, the right fielder, number 16, Ryan Spataro.
Back to the top of the lineup, batting is the right fielder, number 16, Ryan Spataro, and he fouled it way off on top of the arena. Spataro hits it along the ground out to second base. Power throws to first. Finally, the top of the ninth inning is over. It's now a 16-run ball game, and if the Royals want this to keep going, they have to score 16 right here, right now.
For Barrie in the top of the ninth inning, two runs on one hit, one error, and two men left on base.
You know, I'll play this one.
This is Howlin' for You by the Black Keys.
I
just waiting for Cadena to finish warming up. And the leadoff batter for the Royals in the bottom of the ninth will be the first baseman, number 33, Matt Schmidt. Cadena misses outside, ball one. Cadena puts it in the dirt, ball two. Cadena misses outside, 3-0. Cadena throws a strike this time, bottom corner, and it's called. Schmidt fouls one back, strike two, full count now. Swing and a miss from Schmidt. He's out for out number one. Now batting is the designated hitter, number 20, Steven Satz.
The batter, the designated hitter, number 20, Steven Satz.
Satz takes strike one. And he makes a tough call there and takes it low, ball one. 1-1-1. Nobody on. Royals trail by 16. Sats takes strike two on the outside edge. And Sats lets the curveball go by, strike three. He strikes out looking. Now batting is the left fielder, number 5, Aaron Loader.
The batter, the left fielder, number 5, Aaron Loader.
Loader takes ball one outside. Loader pops one off, foul, strike one. Cadena misses high, 2-1. Loader fouls one back, strike two. Now 2-2-2. Cadena's curveball doesn't drop quite enough, ball three. Now a full count with Loader, two out and nobody on. Loader fouls it back, trying to stay alive, picking and choosing. Looking for the 16-run home run here. Joking, of course. Here's the pitch, fouled back again. Loader foul tips it, and catcher gets it. That's it. Strike three. He's out of here. Royals lose 16-0 through nine innings. Baycats do it. 16 runs, 16 hits with no errors. Royals, no runs on three hits with two errors. Thank you very much for listening. My name is Simon Gladstone. It's been a pleasure having you here till the bitter end. I'll see you again on Tuesday. Make sure you tune in. Have a great night.